Hey guys, Robert here. Today I'm going to show you how to make an EDM track using only FL Cloud. If you're wondering what FL Cloud is, don't worry, I'm here to explain. FL Cloud is a service from FL Studio that gives you access to over 1 million royalty-free samples, high-quality plugins, artificial intelligence mastering, and even lets you distribute your music directly through Distrokid. Plus, there are multiple tiers to choose from, including a free option. So let me show you how to create an EDM track with it. First, I will search for some vocals to get some inspiration.
Wait, call me when you need me, and I'll always be there when you call me when you need me.
Next, I will create a bass line using a preset from UVI Synth Anthology 4, which has some great analog sounds. And at the end, I will add some variation. This will be the foundation of our track. From here, I am going to create the breakdown. First, I will create a pluck melody using the bass notes. However, instead of using the same F sharp note, I decided to bring it up to G sharp. For the effects, I used some crazy EQ curves and added a ton of reverb using the crystalline plugin that comes with the FL Cloud subscription. I use the basic Ambiance preset and made the decay longer. What is nice about this plugin is that it has a ducking feature that will let the dry signal breathe a little bit more. Then, to create some groove, I will add a lot of shaker loops and a clap sample. Some of the shakers are hard panned to the left and right to create a wider sound. Next, I am going to create some ambience for the track. I will pick a pad preset from UVI and change the pitch range to 7. Then I'm going to create this kind of automation. Next, we are going to create the build-up. For the build-up, I decided to chop the vocal sample to make it sound different. Then I also changed the notes and sound of the bass for more variation. Next, I will add a heartbeat sample and some claps to create more tension. Then I used a kick and a snare to create the build-up drums and added some risers. And now the most exciting part, the drop. For the drop, I kept the same vocal sample. The only difference is that I added some sidechain with a simple volume automation.
And I'll always be there when you call me, when you need me.
For the bass, I changed once again the sound and used the same notes as in the breakdown. To get this full bass, I layered multiple sounds. First, I started with this analog bass. Then I added a click sample to bring some transients. Then I added a wide bass for the stereo width. And the last layer, which is extremely important, is a fat sub bass. Then the sounds are routed to a bus channel where I applied some EQ and compression. Also, the main bass has an ozone standard that comes with the FL Cloud Pro subscription. I added an imager to make the sound wider and a maximizer for the upward compression. Make sure to check out all the plugins that come with your subscription, because they all are extremely useful. Then for the drum beat, I started with a kick drum. Then I introduced the claps with some fills. And on the second drop, I added some hi-hats and shakers. Also, to make the two drops differentiate, I created a top melody. To get this sound, I layered 3 one-shot samples and 2 presets from UVI. For the effects, I added some EQ together with some stock reverb and delay. And after all the effects, I added a spectral delay from M-Audio to give it some texture. And then I added some support chords. Processing wise, I kept everything very simple with some EQ and the cashmere reverb that has the ducking feature enabled. Also, the vocals have been shortened and pitched up by 12 semitones.
And I'll always be there when you need me.
And make sure to add transition effects and impacts to glue the sections of the track together. Now that we have our track ready, we can master it using the AI mastering from FL Cloud. The process, it's dead easy. Just go to Tools and select Mastering. Then make sure that you have these settings on. Here you can select the loudness of your track. You can go with the existing presets, or you can move the slider for a custom loudness. I will choose the Spotify preset. On the References tab, I will choose EDM, and on the second reference, I will let the algorithm choose. Then we will let the AI do the job for us. Then after the track is rendered, you can take a listen at your AI master. If you want a different sound, you can move these knobs. As you can see, FL Studio made this process extremely simple, that you don't need a lot of mastering experience. You can make your track warmer, wider, or add multiband compression with the click of a button. And after you are happy with the final master, go to Tools and click Distribution. FL Cloud includes distribution via Distrokid as part of the subscription, and you will be able to get your music to over 50 streaming platforms and get paid for your music. Let's see how the final result sounds like.
And I'll always be there when you call me, when you need me.
So if you like this tutorial, make sure to leave a thumbs up and click here if you want to watch more tutorials like this. See you on the next one.